time to time, make your calls. You must pull over and find a tree. Well, Rooster Man is no exception to the tree rule. So Rooster Man, the other night's working. Nature calls. Rooster Man goes to find a tree. Well, he finds a big, huge oak tree. Rooster Man walks up to the oak tree. Rooster Man hears a snort, and it sounded like this. It went, something like that. Anywho, Rooster Man says, "What the dad Jim far was that?" So, Rooster Man pulls his flashlight out, and he shines it beside the tree that he's at, and what does Rooster Man see? Nothing, but I'm telling you, Sharon, the same tree Rooster Man was sharing, was the biggest black bear I have ever seen in my life. I'm talking Grizzly Adams, Big Ben. Now, he stands up, and he's towering like about 2 feet over Rooster Man. Now, Rooster Man ain't no tall nobody, I'll tell you right now. I'm talking 5'7" with his boots on. But still, this bear was standing down the hill, and he stood up, and he was still 2 feet over Rooster Man. Rooster Man did more than just tinkle, I'm going to tell you right now. Woo! Scared Rooster Man to death. Then Rooster Man made a decision to make a tactical, hasty retreat back to his car. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, had Rooster Man not had just drank him some super Rooster Booster drink, that, he might not have made it back to that car. The bear could have ate him, ate the Rooster Man. Now, what would have happened if the bear had ate Rooster Man? There would have been no more Rooster Man. The sadness that would have caused. Tell you right now. The point of this story is, and this is a true story, I'm telling you right now, that when you go into the woods or the forest, you better know who's sharing the same tree you are. Because I'm telling you right now, when Big Ben turned and runned off, he looked like a big old cow running away. Which I was glad he was running away. But anyway, cock-a-doodle-doo, watch out for the bear.